Nigel Farage has done it again. 5 years ago, his UKIP party scared David Cameron into calling a referendum on Britain's EU membership. Now his new Brexit party is on course to win big in the UK's unwanted European elections.
The intelligence I get is that the Brexit party is doing pretty well. The Lib Dems clearly on the Remain side are doing reasonably well. But it looks like there's going to be quite a big win for the Brexit party, yeah.
As the hours passed, the Brexit Party tally of MEPs grew and grew, leaving the traditionally dominant Labour and Conservative parties far behind. It's an astonishing feat considering this party didn't exist before April the 12th. Leave voters have severely punished the Tories for Theresa May's failure to deliver Brexit. Remain voters have deserted Labour over its evasive attitude to a second referendum. Consequently, the Liberal Democrats have done very well, as have the Greens.
What we're left with after these elections is an electorate that is looking for a new political home, both on the Leave side and the Remain side, one that's very sceptical of the two big parties, and one that clearly wants to let the political parties and politicians in Westminster know how they feel.
Nigel Farage, with his message that Britain has been betrayed by its complacent politicians, found the door to victory wide open. Britain only voted in these elections because March's last-minute Brexit deadline extension required it to. The Tories barely bothered to campaign and astonishingly spent the run-up to the vote dethroning their leader. Labour hardly showed much more effort. There's a lesson here for the Tory leadership hopefuls competing to replace Theresa May, and it's a lesson that will concern anyone who's worried for the centre ground of British politics. The next leader of the Conservative Party may well be thinking that if he or she is going to claw back any of the voters that they've just lost, they're going to have to out-Farage Nigel Farage. Rory Challens, Al Jazeera, London.